trod grabbing his head. Yeah. Just that one. Oh, he won't get far enough over. Rob dogs. Oh, it's just tickling it.
Just had a whistle stop visit at Loch Lomond for a wee, and onwards now. We'll look for somewhere to pull in and have a bite to eat, a cup of tea, and the trek down to Gretna. So let's see how things go. Time's 11:41, we're 85 miles in, and the time is 11:42. And this road is bloody busy. Very busy. Wait for the boyos. Kev's here. Fry's here. Paul's here. We're up over the Erskine Bridge now. I'm trying to go down the right hand side of coming in from the north, down the right hand side of Glasgow, so I'm missing Glasgow. I want to avoid motorways down to Gretna. What's the Erskine Bridge? Village or town called Dalry. And I'll try and keep a lookout for somewhere to stop. See if there's some food or anything here. So much going on. Hello, Dalry. And that was Dalry. Good afternoon. Just a check-in with an update of where we are. We've stopped for a bite to eat in Kilmarnock, and we're heading on the A72. A76, sorry, towards Dumfries now. We're 148 miles into the day. It's 4 minutes past two, and we've got an hour and 41 minutes left to get to Gretna, and the day's in. So we should be there before 4 o'clock, and then we can just chill for the rest of the day before heading home tomorrow. So it's Once we got south of Glencoe, wasn't really a great deal to see, so didn't have not a lot of video captured today really. So I'll do a bit closer to Gretna. I'll do another update and then I'll summarise the week to round off this series of videos. Back shortly. Is that you behind me now, Kev? Cool. This stretch of the A76 is bloody lovely. Lots of twisties to keep us entertained. Miles, you beauty. 1 hour from Gretna. Nothing excited coming down to Kilmarnock, and then quite nice down through New Galloway, and then down now, just the final leg. Been on the A75 from Dumfries all the way over to Gretna. Get us there just before 4 o'clock. Reflections on the week. Well, what a week it's been. It's probably been one of the best weeks holidays I've ever had in my whole life. Seeing what I've seen and being able to ride my bike to do it, it's just made it perfect. So yeah, so Monday we left early. Well, not early. We left around 8:30, and we were up to Halt Whistle, up through Lancashire, Yorkshire Dales, part of Northumberland and the North Pennines, up to Halt Whistle. And we had a cracking night in Halt Whistle. Lovely place we stayed, centre of Britain Hotel. And a nice meal at the Indian restaurant in the town. Tuesday, we shot up to, leaving Halt Whistle, we shot up to Kielder. Beautiful sights around Kielder and up on the Adrian's Wall. Shame about the weather on Kielder Reservoir, it was a bit dismal. But then a cracking ride from Kielder up to the Falkirk Wheel. Bit of a disappointment in terms of we were there quite late on and we didn't have a lot of time to really explore properly. But we then jumped on from there to the Kelpies, and the Kelpies were phenomenal. Really lovely, impressive thing to see, the Kelpies. Highly recommended. And then Tuesday night in Perth at the Holiday Inn Express. Great, nice beer and meal, pub around the corner. So that took us on to Wednesday, and we jumped on the left from Perth, headed up towards the Cairngorms with a stop at Glen Shee. Nice and wet and damp up on Glen Shee, but beautiful scenery on the way up there. Absolutely fabulous. Glen Shee, we dropped down to Braemar, had a little walk around Braemar, up to Balmoral. Not a great deal we could do at Balmoral, we had a bit of a poke around. And then from Balmoral, stunning roads all the way up to where we joined the A9, which took us up to Inverness. And then from Inverness, beyond Inverness, the coast road up to Wick. Well, the northern part of it was stunning, absolutely stunning. and we had a great night, pleasant sitting and watch a bit of TV in Wick on Wednesday night before starting the big one, which was Thursday, with a sort of quick noodle up the coast to John O'Groats for the obligatory photo, then across the north coast and through the most amazing scenery that I've ever seen, up to Durness, and a little look around Durness and refuel, and then coming down from Durness, well, I don't know what to say, it was just the most wonderful, wonderful experience that anyone could ever wish for, was to go through that scenery and have the weather be kind to us while we did it, and the landscape was just amazing. So that was for me was the highlight of the week. Nothing can top that. And that dropped us down into Wallapool for Thursday night. Before yesterday, Friday, we headed down the key the coastal roads to from Wallapool down to Applecross. We did Balaclavar. Experience to tick off our bucket list. It wasn't as treacherous as I thought it was going to be, but the views coming down were unimaginably beautiful. So that was another feast for the senses to do that. The sights you were seeing and the skill and care and attention required to bring the bike down and safely around those hairpins. But what an experience. And then the roads then, the sweeping, winding roads through lochs and forests, along lochs and forests, down into Fort William, were just immense. And then today, which I've already talked about today, again we had a few chances to make some real, there's some real wonders today again with Glencoe and lovely to say Loch Lomond today was a bathing in sunshine like he was the last time I was up, and then to have another go at A76 through New Galloway, Dumfries and Galloway, sorry. So that's about it really. That's pretty much the tour done. Just got to get settled in tonight at Gretna. Hopefully we'll find something nice to eat and have a few beers to celebrate what we've done. And then tomorrow the final slog down the M6 back at home, ready for normality to commence on Monday. So that's the summary of the trip. I hope that you've watched the series of videos that preclude this, and that you found it enjoyable, and that you found today's video enjoyable. So I don't know, I'll probably run the camera down as we come down into where we're staying, just to finish the day off. But in terms of the same, the closing of the tour, that's pretty much us done. If you have come along and joined us through the videos, thank you very much for doing so. We're planning begins to see what we need to do next year, and I don't know what I'm going to find that's going to better what we've done this year. So for now, thanks for everything, and I'll see you again soon. Stay in the hotel. And then it's here. How's that? And then we want to go park up the top, preferably right by the entrance. Well, two could go in here, can't they? Two can go in here, whatever space each if you want. And there we are,
yep.
Done.
That's it.
All done.
104 miles since the last time we filmed. 4 years, 3 months.
All done.
All done.
Excellent. Well done, Dave.
All done, Kev.
All done,
Dave. NC500 and Tour of Scotland. Done. Catch you later.